Hello everyone, welcome to my class, and in this math video we're going to talk about multiplying fractions and how to do that. Let's get started. Welcome back to this math video, and again our topic for this video, we are going to solve multiplication of fractions, okay? And to do that, so first let us recall the parts of fraction. So we have here the fraction var, which is called vinculum, and the number above the vinculum is what we call the numerator, and the number below the vinculum is what we call the denominator. And in multiplying fractions, the rule is we are going to multiply the numerator of one fraction to the other numerator, and then you will write the result as the numerator. And then next is we are going to multiply the denominator of one fraction to the denominator of the other fraction, and then the result will be the denominator of the answer. Okay, so let's try this. So 2 times 2, that is 4. Next is we multiply the denominator to the other denominator. So 5 times 7 is 35. So the result is 4 over 35. So 2 over 5 times 2 over 7 is equals to 4 over 35. That's very easy, right? So let's have another problem. That is 6 over 7 times 1/2. This is very easy, right? So again, the rule is multiply the numerator to the other numerator, and then the result will be the numerator of the answer, and then the denominator times to the other denominator, and the result will be the denominator of the answer. So 6 times 1, that is 6. 7 times 2, that is 14. Okay, and as you can see, 6 and 14 are divisible by 2. So let's simplify. 2. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. 14 divided by 2 is 7. So our final answer is 3 over 7. So it is really best that you simplify to the lowest term your final answer. And how to simplify? Just look for a number that you can divide both the numerator and denominator, okay? And the result will be something or numbers that cannot be any more simplified. So that's the lowest term, okay? So now let's have another example. We have 2.5 times 3 2/3. So as you can see in this problem, we are having mixed numbers. When we say mixed number, we have a whole number and a fraction, and before we could multiply that, we need to transform that mixed number into improper, wherein we can only see numerator and denominator, because the rule states that we are going to multiply fractions numerator to numerator and then denominator to denominator. So how are we going to change? So first, let's focus on the first fraction, that is 2.5. So to change this mixed number to improper fraction, 2 times 2, you multiply the denominator to the whole number, that is 2 times 2, that is 4, and then the result, you will add the numerator. So 2 times 2 is 4, plus 1 is equals to 5. Then over 2, just copy the denominator. Next is we are going to transform the second fraction. Again, let us multiply the denominator to the whole number. So 3 times 3, that is 9. And then the result will be added to the numerator. So 9 plus 2, it's 11. Over, just copy the denominator, over 3. So now we can easily multiply them. So 5 times 11, that is 55. Then 2 times 3, that is 6. So our answer in improper fraction is 55 over 6. We say improper fraction because the numerator is greater than the denominator, because the proper fractions is the numerator is lesser than the denominator, but in this case the numerator is greater than the denominator. That's why it is called improper fractions. And to transform improper fraction into mixed number, all we need to do is just divide 55 divided by 6. So 55 divided by 6, that is 9. 9 times 6, that is 54. So 55 minus 54, we have a remainder of 1. So the whole number, 55 over 6, or whole number will be 9. And then our remainder will be our numerator over 6, our divisor. So 55 over 6, or 9 and 1 over 6. That is the result when we multiply 2 and a half times 3 and 2 thirds. So that's all for multiplication of fractions. Oh, bye bye and have a nice day. Love lots.